Hi, I'm David Murphy. I'm here at Mobile World Congress talking to Alex Moukas, CEO of Velti. Alex, good morning.
Hi, Dave.
So, Alex, when people are coming on the stand here at Mobile World Congress, what are the key messages that you're giving out as Velti this year?
Depends who you are.
Okay.
So, we have different groups of people coming by. So we have obviously a lot of mobile operators, a lot of wireless carriers. The big focus there is primarily on ARPU growth and churn reduction. How can we run elaborate loyalty programs or mega promos that allow them to increase their revenue, reduce their churn from their customer, and sort of manage the relation between the brand, the carrier, and the consumer in a mobile way.
Okay. And do you find that the people you're talking to are existing customers who want to take it further, or is there still a large untapped market of operators who just haven't started communicating with the customers in this sort of way yet?
I mean, it's a mix. Operators, even though they own the channel, they just started to move into sort of more advanced engagement models with the mobile. So we try to approach operators like any other brand, that they have some sort of specific requirements, and we treat the fact that they own the channel almost as an incidental. Now, other types of customers that are coming by, a lot of advertising agencies on the media planning. If you look at our MGage media planning tool, really interested in that. Our MGage marketplace that allows people to buy and sell different types of inventory in pretty much real time, where we control the supply side through MobClicks and Cassie, and the demand side through our demand side capabilities. And finally, we actually have a lot of sort of non-carrier, non-agency folks. So we had, believe it or not, a lot of banks come by,
okay.
Some packaged goods companies, some automotive companies, where each one of these want to engage to the mobile channel and reach a different goal. Let's say if you're a car manufacturer, you want to get more consumers in your dealerships for qualified test drives. If you're a retailer, you need incremental, let's say, foot traffic on your retail stores. And we use mobile to essentially achieve that and close the loop.
So obviously people come to an event like this to find out more about mobile marketing. Where do you find their level of knowledge actually is on the subject?
You get more and more, let's say, savvy buyers. So you're looking at different brands out there. The more savvy ones understand that mobile advertising is all about reach. How do you reach the best type of consumer using the right type of inventory on advertising side? Marketing is what follows after the click. So you click on a mobile ad, then what? How do you engage consumers? How do you convert into customers? And more importantly, how do you manage a long-term relationship between a brand and a consumer in the mobile channel? If you look at Velti's business, the vast majority of our revenue and our profitability comes by combining mobile advertising with mobile marketing, more specifically on sort of the long-term management of consumer relationship. So it's not so much about new customer acquisition, where you're doing lead generation, you're throwing things over the wall to the brands out there. It's sort of working with them closely for many years to help them manage that relationship.
Obviously, you're on the acquisition trail big time in 2011. What are the challenges in terms of integrating those businesses that you bought, but at the same time still serving your customers? And are there more acquisitions to come this year?
It's always hard, right? It takes time. You want to make sure that you keep the best of both worlds. The last thing you want to do is take a great entrepreneurial culture and slap, 3,000 sort of SOX regulations on them. So you have to do the right thing, that you're compliant, but you have to make sure that you sort of nature entrepreneurship. You want to make sure that the founders of this company sort of believe the grand vision, stay with the companies to make sure that they execute and eventually become sort of managed, let's say, global parts of Velti. And we've been doing that with our last two or three acquisitions. In terms of more acquisitions, we're really focusing right now on integrating the existing ones, both in terms of technology platforms and also in terms of management. That's going to take us a while.
Okay, final question, Alex. What's going to be big for Velti in particular and for mobile marketing in general this year, would you say?
It's going to be an interesting year. I mean, it starts to feel like that we're... It used to feel like that we're swimming always against the tide, trying to convince people. Right now, you're looking at sort of existing customers, how they're increasing their spending, and you're seeing sort of dramatic increases there on their budget that are specifically allocated for mobile marketing and advertising. You also look at consumers that are starting to understand what are the privacy implications that are sort of critical. Want to make sure everything we do, want to make sure it's sort of opt-in. We want to make sure that the consumer never gets annoyed with, let's say, a brand message, because that's sort of really bad both for the brands and connection to for ourselves. So privacy and sort of making sure that consumers really opt in and really self-select themselves to participate in the campaigns is also going to be critical this year.